As of November 7th, 2021, there are now 49 volcanoes which are actively erupting. These include volcanoes such as Kerensky in Russia, which just produced a major explosive eruption which sent a plume of ash to the east towards Alaska. In Colombia, the volcano known as Nevado del Ruiz also produced a Vulcanian explosion, sending a several kilometer high plume of ash into the sky. With this being said, here are a few of this week's major volcano-related news stories. At the Yellowstone supervolcano, a section of the caldera has been uplifted over the past few months due to volcanic activity. Moving away from Earth on the planet of Venus, new evidence has emerged that the planet still contains active volcanoes, including a volcano which may have erupted as recently as only a few years ago. Back on Earth in Iceland, a swarm of earthquakes hit the Torfajökull volcano, which adds to the list of volcanoes in the country undergoing above normal levels of activity. But first, I want to note a new eruption which increased the total number of erupting volcanoes from 48 to 49. On Wednesday, November 3rd at 6:46 a.m. local time, a phreatic explosion occurred at the Turrialba volcano in Costa Rica. This sent a plume of ash 200 meters above the volcano's main crater, which at its base is more than 3,200 meters or 10,500 feet above sea level. This eruption lasted for a minute, after which the eruption ended. Phreatic eruptions typically occur due to the heating of abundant groundwater or water in a volcanic crater, which causes it to flash to steam. Eventually, the steam becomes so highly pressurized that an explosion occurs. This phreatic eruption was on the lower end of how explosive these eruptions can be, indicating only a small amount of water was involved. At the Yellowstone supervolcano in Wyoming, the ground surrounding the Norris Geyser Basin has been uplifted by volcanic activity. However, it has only been pushed upwards by 1.5 centimeters or 0.6 inches over the span of several months. If I was to see a similar amount of uplift at a much smaller volcano such as Belknap Crater in Oregon, it would be enough to raise the alert status of the overall volcano. This is because the overall volcano is implied to have a small volume magma chamber. On the other hand, supervolcanoes such as Yellowstone contain massive magma chambers, with volumes often exceeding 1,000 cubic kilometers of molten rock. Because there is a high volume of molten rock underneath Yellowstone, small intrusions and withdrawals of magma are incredibly common and are thus not a cause for concern. Such events at supervolcanoes often occur for thousands of years before an eruption takes place. Besides, the uplift so far is significantly less energetic than other episodes of uplift at Yellowstone over the past two decades, the most energetic of which uplifted part of the caldera by a rate of 5.9 inches or 15 centimeters each year. On Venus, which is just slightly smaller in size than Earth, the crust of the planet is almost completely volcanic in origin. Much of it is basalt, originating from ancient volcanoes and flood basalt mega-eruptions which encompassed much of the planet. Today, more than 1,600 volcanic structures are visible on the planet, the vast majority of which are towering shield volcanoes, which were all thought to be extinct. Yet, recent evidence has suggested that at least one volcano, termed Idun Mons, is still active on this hellish planet. Surrounding its summit are a series of young-looking lava flows which have seemingly not been corroded by the harsh atmosphere of the planet. Part of this lava flow coincided with a constant heat source, indicating either a fumarole or that the lava was still cooling. More studies are needed to determine how young these flows are, but they are likely younger than 1,000 years in age. In Iceland, several volcanoes are currently at a raised alert status. At Askja, uplift of the overall volcano has continued due to an intrusion of magma at a depth of 2 to 3 kilometers. However, in recent days, emphasis has been placed on the Turrialba volcano to the west. This highly explosive rhyolite volcano, which has not erupted since 1477, just produced a series of long-period volcanic earthquakes. Although the source of these earthquakes is unknown, it could be due to the movement of magma underlying the volcano. Thus, in the next several weeks, a close eye needs to be kept on Geldingadalur, Askja, Grímsvötn, and Turrialba. Here's a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.